today we're at Powis Castle.
We're going to take you along with us. We're most excited about the coffee experience.
Coffee.
But we're also going to be walking around the gardens and going into the castle. We hope you enjoy.
Powis Castle, or Castell Powis, as it's known in Welsh, is a 13th century medieval castle, fortress and grand country house near Welshpool in the county Powis in Mid Wales, UK. A standard adult ticket is £15 and £7.50 for children. You may be wondering why the prices are a little on the high side. This is because the castle is owned by the National Trust, the largest conservation charity in Europe, whose aim is to preserve historic and natural sites. They also aim to open these protected sites for the public to enjoy. If visiting historical sites is something you find yourself doing on a regular basis, purchasing a National Trust membership might be worth looking into. As a couple, we could purchase a joint membership for £139.20 per year or £11.60 per month. A few perks with this membership is that it allows you access to 500 National Trust sites and gives you free parking at most of these sites.
We're walking down to the gardens now and they're absolutely massive. I think what we're both looking forward to the most is experiencing coffee in the garden.
Coffee.
What the hell am I doing here?
We visited the castle in April, but we'd recommend visiting in the summer months when the garden is at full bloom. On this note, if you're wanting to bring your furry friend along for a day out, just know that dog access is limited to the main car park and courtyard during March and October. Your furry friend will only be allowed to access the castle gardens from November to February, as these are the quieter winter months. The Courtyard Cafe does have light bites and snacks to eat, but if you're vegan or gluten-free like me, this might be a big letdown, as all I was able to eat was a packet of crisps. The coffee also wasn't our favourite. Unfortunately, the garden coffee shop was closed when we visited, so we suggest eating before you visit the castle or maybe calling ahead to see if the coffee shop will be open on the day you're wanting to visit.
Hey guys, just wanted to close off. Thank you very much for watching the video. There were a few things that we missed out from myself. I just wanted to let everybody know, as far as we can recall, because it was quite a while ago, the actual site had accessibility to the courtyard, up to the courtyard. But as far as I can remember, the gardens themselves and to get into the castle, it was all stairs without a ramp. So that's just something to take into note.
We just wanted to say it is definitely worth a day trip, especially if you are looking for something to do. We were bored the one day and I think it was cold the day we went, so we didn't really want to go down to the coast or anything like that, but we did want to get out of the house, and it is definitely a beautiful place to go and see. We weren't able to take any footage inside the actual castle, so we couldn't show you any of the, I think they had art installations and historical installations in the castle that I think they do change. And unfortunately we weren't able to video those, but it definitely is worth having a look out and going to visit. So we do hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to follow us for more. And please just be kind, like, we are new to all of this and we're just doing it for fun, so just be kind to us. We will get better. I hope. Anyway guys, have a lovely Sunday. Bye.
Bye.